Hi, I'm Sonia Curtis. I'm a licensed real estate agent with the Real Estate Concierge in Beverly Hills. Today, I wanted to talk about a pocket listing and what is called dual agency. So a pocket listing is when a seller decides to sell his property with a listing agent, but they don't want to market it on the internet or on the MLS. Realtor.com, Zillow, Trulia, etc., all of those places. They want to keep it on the DL, and perhaps it's for privacy concerns. Sometimes you have someone who is famous or has a lot of expensive artwork in their home, and they don't want open houses and people coming and going in their house. So they will have a pocket listing, which means that the agent is representing the seller to find a buyer for the property, but just has to go through their own contacts and the network of local area real estate agents that may have a buyer looking for a property like they're selling. Normally on a listing contract, the percentage is not set by law or by region, but in general, currently the Los Angeles going rate is about 5%. It used to be 6% before the crash started to happen at the end of 2007-2008, where the real estate market just crashed. And now it's more customary to be at 5%. Of the 5%, the listing agent takes half, and the buyer, the agent representing the buyer, or the selling agent it's referred to, gets half. So if the contract was for 5%, the selling agent representing the buyer gets 2.5%, and the listing agent representing the seller gets 2.5%. That's how it generally works. Sometimes there's what's known as a broker listing advantage, which means that the listing agent made a deal with the seller that if they can procure the buyer themselves without having to share the commission with a buyer's agent, they will give the seller a reduced fee for the commission. Like instead of 5%, maybe they'll sell for 4%. So it can work out well for the listing agent to represent both the buyer and the seller to get 4% rather than 2.5% if they only represent the seller. And it can help the seller because it gives them a discounted commission from 5% to 4%. Sometimes, because the market is so flooded with so many agents and it is so competitive to get listings, some listing agents are willing to take the listing for less commission and then still have to give the 2.5% to the buyer's agent. The reason behind that is that we want to sell the property, and to make it more enticing to agents who represent buyers, we want them to come to your property, the seller's property that we're listing. So it would be shooting ourselves in the foot to offer less commission to the buyer's agent. So a lot of people don't understand in real estate. I've talked to many people who think that whenever you're the listing agent, you get 5 or 6% of the house, total sale of the house, as soon as the house sells. It doesn't work that way. Also, we all work for brokers, unless we're licensed brokers and not licensed real estate agents. Most are agents, which mean we're not allowed to transact any real estate unless we have a broker. And brokers get a split of every deal as well, just FYI. So for those of you who think that we just make a ton of money without doing a lot of work, I used to think that too until I became a licensed real estate agent. Now I'm becoming a broker, and I kind of have learned otherwise. Anyways, dual agency is when you represent both parties. You represent the seller and the buyer. You have to exercise extreme fiduciary diligence because it is your duty as a licensed agent to represent the seller with fiduciary due diligence as well as the buyer. It can get a little tricky, but as long as you have integrity and you do everything above the board and you follow all the rules and have everybody sign all the appropriate contracts and disclosures, it should be fine. Thank you. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me.